So it was a very collaborative process once I think I kind of found the character or who he was a bit.
You know? Okay.
That's great.
I love that.
Bill, just to go back real quick to when you guys were young, when you described what your family was like and making these movies, it's my family. It's my younger brother's actually in London right now studying film, but that's what he would do. And he recently, I was murdered in his last movie that he did before he left. But, I love that he has that and we can keep that. Do you guys have anything that's that old that you've kept?
Oh, well, sure. I mean, we have all the Super 8 movies digitized and that every family occasion was finished with a show with
I have to do that.
Kids, dancing routines, yep. Little improvised skits. It was constantly
great.
Show business during the parties.
I do have a collection of the Super 8s. I have to get it digitized. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Before they dissolve or something, yeah. You should go save them.
Bill, I was just on your IMDb, and you were part of a pretty huge viral video. The Muppets doing Bohemian Rhapsody.
Oh, sure, yeah.
That was one of those videos that just made the rounds over and over and over again. Which voice did you do for that?
Oh, gosh. Again, there's Dr. Teeth, Ralph, a character named Bobo. I think Johnny Fiam is in there. Pepe's in there. Carl, the big mean monster's in there. I don't know. There's all different ones.
Wow. It's interesting because we have a time now where the CGI stuff, you know, you'll characters can be rendered pretty quickly and so on and so forth, but they still have to be voiced. I assume that you know, that doesn't impact what you guys do, even though the Henson Workshop is more physical puppets, but do you do a lot of that regular Pixar type voicing as well?
I do a little bit. I haven't done a whole lot. It's usually with friends or someone asked me to come and do something. But
You did some voices on Kim Possible, the series.
Oh, Kim Possible. Okay.
Yeah.
You know what, Bill? I'd never known. I just did a quick search on Bobo the Bear.
Oh.
I had never known his name was Bobo. I just called him the Bear. That's one of my favorite characters.
He's a bad guy
in that Muppet movie. Yeah. I mean, he has this constant scowl on his face.
Yeah,
that is just hilarious.
Pretty, yeah, he's and you know people they like to put him in these bad guy roles, but he's not really bad. He's just hoping that nobody notices he's that he's out in the world. Like he's so happy that people are just letting him get away with wearing a suit and being around people.
Right.
You know, so he just kind of like hangs back. And if they say be a bad guy, he says, okay, you know, I'll be a bad guy.
Do you have a favorite character that you particularly like to portray?
It's one of the genes, isn't it?
It's got to be that gene carrier, the big orange one.
Not necessarily. I mean, I think I like different ones for, just depending on what they're doing or things that, you know, situations that they're in can be, it varies. I'm not one. I guess I'm probably most like Bobo in some way, most ways. So he's probably more like me. So maybe it's easier and more comfortable to do, but not so much a favorite.
Is there a favorite that you have that you don't portray of the Muppet family? I mean, not one that you really, I mean, the one that you just really, that's kind of endearing to you.
Yeah, well, I think my favorite, and Gene, I don't know if this might be Gene's, I don't know if it's yours or not, Gene, but my favorite's always been there was a guy on Sesame Street named Guy Smiley.
Oh,
I love Guy Smiley.
Yes. Yes.
He was the host.
Game show host.
He was the best. I just thought that energy and that, he was just hysterical, and he's one of my favorites.
Who voiced him?
Jim. That was Jim.
Wow. There you go.
My friend Will's favorite, and I'd never really thought about it, but his favorite character of all those the Muppets and Sesame Street would be, he just called him the roundhead guy. He would just play
Big
like
a
citizen. He was just like a...
Big Blue.
That's his name?
Yeah.
So he was like man on the street. When they needed a crowd scene, they'd stick
Jerry
him
Nelson.
In there somewhere.
Yeah.
Really? Mm-hmm. Wow, there's so many characters.
I find it really interesting that the least dynamic character is the ringleader of them all, as far as the Muppets are concerned, Kermit the Frog.
He's a humble guy.
Yeah, yeah. But
a lot like Jim, I suppose, you know, that he...
that's what we heard, yeah.
He tried to keep the chaos, you know, in a sense, kind of control the chaos in a way. You know, he just brought all these crazy people around him, and then he just let them do their thing and tried to figure out a way of coexisting with them, you know, which is a lot like Kermit.
So, Gene, with the writing and the children's stuff and things of that nature, have you ever considered working with your brother, collaborating on a script or something?
Well, we have collaborated on a script. It stayed in development.
Yeah.
And I've worked on some character designs for projects that he's been behind.
It's got to be a blast.
Yeah, and we love to get the opportunity to be in the same place and be working together.
Right.
It doesn't happen often enough, but we keep looking forward to the next one.
Oh, that's cool. Yeah. It's wild that out of the family, you both gravitated, both brothers gravitated in a similar portion of the entertainment industry. It's cool.
Yeah. And have you guys seen his books? I mean, they're...
Yeah, we got gifted.
Yes.
Yeah.
They're just amazing. I mean, just the characters and just the ideas behind these books, they're so good. I mean... And you know, it's amazing. I think we both ended up doing things along the lines that we always wanted to do, I think, as kids. And Gene was drawing ever since I think he could hold a pencil. Mm-hmm. And I always wanted to kind of go in the acting thing. And we've kind of ended up doing, I think, the things that we love, which is a really lucky, fortunate thing to be
that's
doing.
Great.
Yeah, I mean, that's why I've always wanted to collaborate with him.
Yes. It's been a dream of Casey's ever since he walked into the studio.
Yeah. Bill, is Jason Segel involved in the next Muppet movie at all?
You know what, I think maybe in a cameo sense, but I don't, not in the whole film.
No. Okay. And we're probably at least talking another year or more before we'll see it in the theaters.
Christmas, probably.
Oh, really? Okay. Cool.
This Christmas.
I think. Yeah, tomorrow.
Tuesday.
And what's that?
Do you mind if I mention my new
title? No, I was just going to ask you about that.
Sure. The latest one I have out is called Timeless Thomas, How Thomas Edison Changed Our Lives.
Okay.
And
book.
It's all about how children can look around their world and see where these things come from, and it's just part of an inventor series. I did Ben Franklin and Leonardo da Vinci. Just a way to let kids look around their homes and say, oh, I know who's responsible for this.
It's cool.
So that's that's been the latest release.
I always loved that stuff as a kid, that peek into history in an approachable way.
Do you have a website where all of your material is available? Or?
Well, yeah. I mean, you can buy the books anywhere books are sold. But if you want to see the titles, please visit GeneBaretta.com. And it's okay. Two R's and two T's.
And how about
and I want to tell all the parents, okay, all the peoples out there, okay, you gotta get these books, okay? They're incredible.
Checks in the mail.
And I get 10% of the fund.
That's great. Well, Bill, good luck with the rest of the activity over there in London. Any time frame when you'll be back in the States?
Probably maybe April, May, something like that.
Wow. Okay. You're there for a while. You gonna go and visit him at all, Gene?
We haven't talked about it yet.
No, he's not allowed into the
airport. No, okay. Yeah.
They watch me at the airport.
Yeah.
Right.
He can't make it through Heathrow.
Well, excellent. Yeah, Bill and Gene, you guys, you make kids and adults both happy, and that's a wonderful thing. We need a lot of that right now.
Thank you.
So it's excellent to have you guys both on. Thanks so much, Bill. Good luck with everything, okay?
Thank you so much, Bill. Thank you very much.
All right, take care. And Gene, awesome to meet you, man.
Nice to meet you.
Thanks, and we look forward to the Casey book coming out in 2013.
Do you have a suit? Pseudonym or pen name?
Oh, no.
Huh.
Right. I'll come up with some.
Taco Bell. Right?
Taco Bell.
No, that's my pilot name.
That's your pilot name. That's right. Well, by the way, Bill's, and we'll link these on PrestonandSteve.com. We do have their Twitter accounts, and that's at JF Lama.
Jay Fiamma.
Jay Fiamma.
That's one of his characters, Johnny Fiamma.
Oh, okay. And then you're just Gene Beretta.
Right.
At Gene Beretta, which is very cool. Well, thank you, man. Awesome. I'm so glad you made it in here in studio.
Me too. I'm glad you're better.
Thank you, man. Oh, God. I would have been here, but I felt horrible.
Yeah.
All right. Well, listen, thanks. Let's hear it for Gene.
Thank you.
The Preston and Steve Show.